For people who have limited mobility due to stroke or a spinal cord injury, for example, the prospects of walking independently again one day can seem unattainable. However, there's a new technology being used by physical therapists at Berkshire Medical Center that's helping people make significant gains in their gait and independence. It's called an exoskeleton, and the device costs $160,000. Connecting Point's Carolee McGrath has more.
We went to first grade together and then continued on in this small Catholic school and started dating in ninth grade. Actually,
Stephen and Sharon Cronin have been married for 38 years. They have two grown children and a granddaughter. Stephen has always been an avid athlete. He played soccer at the college level, enjoys golf, and has run three Boston marathons.
Straighten that knee.
But these days,
tall on the left, tall.
Stephen has been training for a marathon of a different kind.
We're so much more reserved.
When there's a camera here.
It's been tough. Been the toughest thing I've ever had to deal with, both mentally and physically.
Stephen suffered a brain hemorrhage in March of 2018, which caused paralysis on his left side.
We were immediately airlifted to Mass General Hospital. The team was waiting for us, and as soon as we arrived, everything happened very quickly.
Tall. You're doing good with the weight shift.
Stephen spent 13 months in Boston. Sharon moved out there from Dalton to help him in his recovery, but they both wanted to come home to the Berkshires.
Great job. Left, right. Pause. Great job, Stephen. Left, right.
That's really good.
And with the help of a team from Berkshire Medical Center, he continues to make strides.
It's either cry or sweat.
Physical therapists Jessica Della Gelfa and Tom Berkery have been using the exoskeleton, which helps Stephen improve his walking.
It's a robotic device that is fit to a person, and it has motors and a computer system and a gyroscope in it that is able to tell where the person is in space, how much assistance they need to stand, and then how much assistance they need to walk. So the motors will actually physically help move the person into the walking pattern.
Push that left hip forward.
Jessica says it has helped Stephen build up his endurance. He's able to walk further with the exoskeleton and has improved so that he can walk more frequently with a cane.
I wasn't in this wheelchair all weekend. I walked in and out of restaurants and my son's house with just the cane and some support from Sharon, just being there in case I stumbled or tripped. But I was fortunately able to do that, where months and months ago, I wouldn't have been able to even attempt it.
We put you back in an easier mode, Steve.
Thanks.
You feel how much easier this is?
Yeah.
The Center for Rehabilitation has had the exoskeleton for about a year, and it's the only one in use from the Albany area to Boston.
He's moving that left leg good today.
I know. We worked on Friday him being more aggressive with it.
Like, we've had several patients who were not walking at home, and now they are. You know, and that's a big life-changing level of function.
Stephen goes to therapy at BMC twice a week, and Sharon brings her little black notebook to keep track of all of the cues and strategies Jessica and Tom give him.
I think it's very important that I've learned for Stephen to use the same language. So, you know, shift to the left or stand up tall.
For the couple who first met on the playground all those years ago, this has been a long journey.
Sharon, she's like my guardian angel. She's been right there since day one when I got sick. I can't say enough what she's done for me. I owe a great deal of gratitude. She's been like my guardian angel.
And with each step, they're getting stronger together.
We are so grateful and wake up every morning that we're with each other. So we thank God for that, that we're each day, we're here together.
Each day, march on, keep plugging.
Right.
Thanks.